Good morning, everybody. Thank you so much, Dr. Laxmi, for giving us this opportunity to discuss a very important topic of preconceptional care, which all of us as gynecologists can do really well and make a difference in the society. Especially when this conference is basically focused on infertility, as gynecologists, we get more and more opportunities to encounter, to have an encounter with these patients who are in the reproductive age group. So basically coming to, without much ado, I'll come straight away come to the main points. Basically, preconceptional care is the provision of biomedical, behavioral, social interventions to women and couples before conception occurs to address the health problems, behaviors that could lead to health problems, and individual or environmental risk factors that could contribute to maternal or childhood mortality and morbidity. Its ultimate aim is improved maternal and child health outcomes. What are the objectives of preconceptional care? As we all know, it encourages the adoption of healthy lifestyle and supplements the preconception diet and the preconception diet with correct vitamins. The health women health status should be evaluated preconceptionally to identify many medical problems that may worsen or complicate a pregnancy, which includes a preterm birth, fetal growth anomalies, birth defects, infections of the baby, serious complications during pregnancy and delivery, baby's susceptibility to develop health problems throughout their life, such as obesity, high blood pressure, heart disease, diabetes, lung disease, and some forms of cancer, problems caused by pre-existing cardiovascular disease or diabetes in the mother, and death of the mother or baby. So these are the key components of a preconceptional care. Preconceptional care actually should begin with very three important points of 5 A's, which all of you can just take up. The 5 A's comprise of ask, assist, advise, and arrange. And a good idea is to keep a ready checklist with all of us in the OPD. Since we meet many women every day in our OPD in the reproductive age group, this checklist, which is actually available online but can be modified as per our practice settings and the kind of population you are dealing with. And this can be actually kept in the OPD waiting area, and we can have the checklist ready. And so can we can assess more and more women in that age group and make our own data. So having given that checklist, when the patient comes in, there are around 14 components of a preconceptional care. First and foremost is the timing of pre-pregnancy counseling. Consider each visit of any woman in that age group as an opportunity for preconceptional counseling. It is appropriate whether reproductive age patient is currently using contraception or planning a pregnancy, because health status and risk factors can change over time, and pre-pregnancy counseling therefore should occur several times during her reproductive lifespan. Second important component is family planning and pregnancy spacing. It is a foundational aspect of the counseling, because even in a country like United States, even now, 45% of the pregnancies are still unintended. And as we all know, unintended pregnancy increases the risk of pregnancy complications. The third important component is review of medical, surgical, and psychiatric history. Many chronic medical conditions such as diabetes, hypertension, psychiatric illnesses, thyroid diseases have implications on pregnancy outcomes and therefore should be optimally managed well before pregnancy. And therefore, a detailed history is extremely important. The fourth component is consider reviewing of her current medications. All prescriptions and non-prescription medications should be reviewed during pre-pregnancy counseling. And this review should also include nutrition supplements and herbal products that the patient may not consider as medication, but they could affect her reproduction and pregnancy. The pregnancy safety of each medication supplement should be discussed with the patient, and also we should also discuss if she's taking common cosmetic treatments for acne and all, which they think is just a beauty treatment. The fourth component is review of medical and genetic history. A genetic and family history of the patient and her partner should be obtained. And this includes history of genetic disorders, which history of common hemoglobinopathies like thalassemia and sickle cell disease, birth defects, mental disorders, breast, ovarian, and uterine colonic cancers, and consanguineous marriage, which is also very important. When any genetic carrier status is diagnosed in one or both the partners, full medical records review and genetic counseling must be recommended. Sixth very important component is immunization, and the CDC recommendations are women of reproductive age should have their immunization status assessed annually for Tdap, MMR, hepatitis B and varicella. All patients should receive an annual influenza vaccine. Those women who are and will be pregnant during the influenza season should have additional benefits. Time is done. Okay, then I'll just quickly go through other objectives. Then rubella vaccination, one very important point in this, rubella vaccination in the recent past should be discussed with the patients. Many times patients are not aware about the 3 months contraceptive window. Infectious disease screening should be done, which would be STI screening, gonorrhea, chlamydial infection, syphilis, HIV, herpes simplex, and hepatitis screening should be considered. Then please do take a minute to discuss about exposure to violence, intimate partner violence, sexual and reproductive coercion. Substance use assessment is very important current generation, because drugs, alcohol, smoking has become very common. Assessment of teratogens, environmental and occupational hazards should be discussed if the woman is working in some laboratories or in some radiation department, something like that. That's also very important. Then pregnancy dating. The woman should be counseled about her fertile period if her cycles are regular. So that will help us in dating of the pregnancy, because if pregnancy is correctly dated, then treatment can be modified during pregnancy. Coming to the general factors where you have to assess nutrition status, do consider general measures, counseling about her healthy diet, avoidance of junk food, importance of adequate sleep, and supplementation folic acid. For a low-risk patient, about 400 micrograms, and in a patient with a moderate, average, or high risk, should be given 4 milligrams of folic acid every day. Importance of exercise and physical activity, extremely important, because more and more women are following a sedentary lifestyle these days. So the recommendations are minimum of 150 minutes of moderate exercise per week. And another very important factor, as gynecologists, we tend to neglect, is the male partner. So we all must counsel them about the age of the father, because it has been found that increased father's age has been associated with increased genetic mutations, increased chances of ASD in the baby, increased chances of mental disorders. Autism is seen with babies with increased father's age. And if the father is taking any medications, also should be reviewed, especially corticosteroids, tetracyclines, and calcium channel blockers, which are now commonly used. So these also affect the outcome. Also discuss vices of the father, like alcohol, smoking, tobacco, all this must be discussed. So these form the very important 14 components of preconceptional care, and the global consensus is that preconceptional care is important and can be done at each opportunity that you have in your clinic. We must set our sight on the objective that preconceptional care is being done, it is being done well, and is making a big difference. Thank you very much.